you very much. And the session today is about the flow. My flow is not a true definition. Plus computing, my definition because I like it. And the first question for you is how many people use compute for your work or testing or other? Outside, in the internet side, is a property. You use Amazon. No one uses internet built-in. The agenda of today is a little bit introduction, probably going to give you some definition about cloud computing. And because cloud computing is very, very young, and we don't have a true definition, we don't have an environment very well defined today. And I'd like to explain two main software today as openQRM and Eucalyptus. One is more overview of openQRM, of handle infrastructure, and Eucalyptus is a new way to the true cloud computing paradigm. The first question is, what is cloud computing? You can find from Wikipedia from 2007 this definition. And it's very generic in such a way. You can add something scalable dynamically. Okay? And not that the partner in 2009 tried to define computing. Probably Gartner spent a lot of millions of euros to copy the Wikipedia definition. And I bet that work is by NICT, working definition. You can understand that it's very important because we are already in version 13 of this definition. On this definition, we try to define the resource, network server, and so on. In a special way, we define five essential characteristics. We define three delivery models and four deployment models. This is the first time we try to give you a definition of the environment. What kind of environment you can put your computer. The five essential characteristics is on-demand service. It's very famous. You can start by your own or your machine. Self-service. You don't ask IT manager to start up a virtual machine on virtual center, for example, or another infrastructure, or IT take a hardware, put in a rack, put cable on switch, turn on in solo packages. Self-service is first. The second, you don't know where you are independent from the network. You can do everything from everywhere. The resource, your data, your information, also the information are independent of the location. You can keep the storage on one side and your calculation or CPU power on the other side. But everything is spread around. It must be also rapid and elastic. But if you need more CPU, more RAM, more machine, you can make it immediately. Immediately probably is not right. And last, and that is important for IT manager, from a technical point of view, the measure. The measure is you can translate in cost because you can handle the cost of infrastructure. And if the infrastructure is dedicated to the support, you can understand how much the cost of this work is. Not IT cost, it's the cost of the application. And you can put this cost on marketing, on other department. Yes, your budget can be free from this cost. In delivery model, we have three delivery models. We talk many times about computing, but computing is a lot of things. On the bottom, we have cloud infrastructure. That means you don't care about the hardware. It's not on your device, it's not a one-way infrastructure. It's also firewall, router, switch, VLAN, and storage. It's all the hardware that you don't care. You don't buy this. It's not administrative task. It's out of scope. That means you start from a criticism. Your responsibility starts from the operation. Handle the criticism. Not the hardware. Not the firewall. And so on. So, completely by any means. Platform as a third that removes a certain way the work of a system administrator because you deploy your application in an infrastructure. You don't handle the middleware, database, application server, web server. You create your application, you deploy this application infrastructure. This is more a service that you can handle the operating system. You can handle the size of your storage. The top of the model is an application. You don't write application. You use application. You make administration of the application to someone. It's not yours. This is the three type of app. The different models. We have three different models. Yeah, the first is private. Use the word domestic because it gives you the idea that it's your domestic things give you because give you more of this information. But in another way, you can use a private code from outsourcer. It's not, you don't need to build in your house. You can use a private only for you, but from IBM, for example. Public law, probably everyone knows public law, Amazon, that's public. But today, there is a very interesting solution. This is a mix in the IBM code. That you can use a private law for testing, for example, for your internal application, and use public law for your public service or for testing, because you don't want to spend a lot of money in hardware and you make the testing public without data. And move that in internal private integers. That is a new solution. Why type a private load? What is the advantages of private load? The advantage is the control. If you are IT manager, probably you don't like to think that everything is outside of your control. The second is the security. The same. You can control the firewall, you can control the CL, you can control everything. But privacy in your everything in your building probably is more secure. Probably, I'm not sure. We already said it's important to understand how much is the cost of infrastructure and the value for service. If you are an IT manager, probably you are worried to set up, if you are a system administrator to set up operating system, start, mount, and so on. Self-service is a very nice task because you demand the start to the final user. You can spread around your infrastructure if you are more than one branch. And if you need to test some new solution to be instrument enterprise, if you want to test some new software, you need 3, 4, 5, sometimes 10 machines because you put a database of a backend, a lot of work. And you need hardware, you need a machine, and many other things. With a cloud computing, you start, and you can sell it if you don't need that. Without problem, is everything automatically made. And then you have a cloud manager inside your company. This is a, for me, obviously, advantage to use a private. In the comparison of the two software, we try to understand what kind of change button we use is the user from these two software. The type of storage you can use, where the is storing, because it's around there, and I don't know, it's in the cloud. No, probably the background. How can interface you have to make integration in your application or your environment. And at the hand, is the last thing is all not development is how to deploy the skill on how to deploy the machine and give priority on the machine. Today, the environment is very young and we have a huge, a lot of things that is in 2008. We have company, we have SaaS infrastructure for those software. We have a lot of. We don't have a good definition. We don't have a good definition in development. We don't have the best software or best solution. We have a very big tree and a lot of questions, probably more than solution. We jump. First, software we could use for code, for domestic, for installing company, is the openQRM. OpenQRM is the by nature, come from a data center management, more than a global computing. The big advantage is a full behavior. Many features, many functions is a plugin, made by a plugin. Already inside, already have a monitoring system that is very important for IT infrastructure. It's high availability. And today, you have closed the interface of closed workflow we will see in the next few slides. For me, one of the most important things about openQRM is a multi-virtualization system that you can use one web, XM, and all the virtualization system present for today. On the market. That is a big, is an important feature. Why is it important for me? Because I come from the work in a company that's working in a business environment. I'm a architect in a certain way. I'm an architect on the infrastructure, storage, and data platform. That platform for me is a software that gives you access to the infrastructure. For example, when you turn on perform, iPhone, yeah, there is a database that gives you, you can connect and so on. For me, it's not a platform. It's not accepted very well if you use the Xeno KVM enterprise environment. You can spoke sometimes one where solution. Yeah. All Solaris is a good solution. But in enterprise, the person in every company can understand that the open software. And if you want to introduce open software, you need to attach a big company like OpenWare. OpenWare also have an API that you can connect with the program and can use different types of storage, classical storage. How this works, we can divide the OpenWare world in two main parts. One is the storage part. One is the hardware for computation. We can define this way the storage server, where you put your information. A file system image, where file system image is a file system, your user, etc, and so on. A boot image, a kernel, and a virtual environment, that is a combination of the two. What is the combination of the two? We can understand how OpenQRM start your machine. The idea is a few years ago for OpenQRM was to put hardware and turn on. You don't need to install anything. Then, how can that by simple fix the boot? You can find the PFS in the machine and start up with the PFS. The pixel retrieve from TCP IP address, receive also the TFTP in the name of the kernel to start up. Then, execute, retrieve the kernel in the main, you start up the openQRM engine inside the next major, can retrieve information, what can do next. Mount an extra storage, your file system image. For this reason, we can say file system and kernel flywheel separate, because you can use different hardware. You start right up the right kernel, right hardware with the same image. This combination is a different environment. This is true for hardware, but also for the virtual environment, because you have also a virtual environment. But you can start what you want, where you want. You don't have to. Virtualize and also control the machine, and you can start stop and many other control. That's simple. Yeah. Okay. The first idea of current was one single image for one hardware. To start the machine, your image. And the idea was not to deliver a virtual machine. The idea was to deliver an application. Inside the OpenQRM, you have a puppet. Do you know puppet? How many people know puppet? Puppet? Okay. Give a small definition. Puppet. Puppet is configuration and deployment management. With Puppet, you start your machine, you can deploy the web server and give the right configuration. Because all the data in the storage image and the storage server, you deploy the application, not the virtual machine. This is the first idea of all. The second is if you need, you can deploy the same image on more than one machine. For example, if you have 10 web servers with the same information, you can start up the same image on all the machines, because all the information are stored in the backend. This is a good idea. This is not a limitation, because you can use also other information. Today, we use more machine, and we have a partition design. On the single machine, you have more different machine. This is the three main distribution that you can do. On the storage layer, we have FF, that is common, but you can use iSCSI. Also, are supporting some specific hardware on the storage network, and can use advanced option of, for example, NetApp. The OpenQRM can use function of NetApp to make clone image or system. But however, this you can use also local disk. You can install your machine and put under control of OpenQRM. PSA is not the solution. You lose advantage, but you can. And this is very nice feature, but, and also three consent way. And if you deploy a major machine, the OpenQRM make a event, lock this NFS, then you can immediately and you copy and then after, depends on the size of the draft or your information, you have local information and speed up the speed of read and operation. That's, this is very funny for me. Failover. This is a network solution. Work for data center, you have three types of failover. First is quite simple, hardware is not responding, and automatically preserve made on other hardware. That's quite good for data center. The second, you need to configure, because you measure the performance of your application, and if something goes wrong, you can start hardware. This is a little bit more complicated, but you can do that. And also OpenQRM, all information is on OpenQRM. You can put OpenQRM in availability environment, it has a solution for master level. And also in this way, you can, you don't lose the control of your infrastructure, because this is the head of your infrastructure. Everything starts from OpenQRM system. No. On the policy scheduler, the virtual machine are deployed on the first machine available. But machine that use numeric sources or use the source user. Also, the user can increase and decrease some parameter about the resource user on the application. And today it's possible also to make a workflow from provisioning that is more cloud computing. You make a request, you declare when you need, when you need to remove, and so on. Automatically is created and stopped. In OpenQRM, you have a monitoring system that is very important. You know, and there's something that we adjust. And also, you can your metrics and make some events independent from Nagios. But in Nagios, you can integrate automatically from Nagios when you deploy OpenQRM, is automatically configured and so on. This is not a cloud computing task. On cloud computing, unfortunately, I don't have enough time to show you the funny interface about OpenQRM. It's a completely drag and drop. You have a hardware, you have a box, and drag CPU, RAM, and so on. To in your hardware, that is quite nice. And you have a user interface, you have you declare for this user limit, that's resources, hardware, CPU, and storage, the limit size. And also, you can integrate the puppet for deploy a specific parameter about the application. And today, I can give you a web service for all this function that you can invoke on CRM with web service. That's more simple to integrate with in your environment. And another development is you can test that integration with Amazon and make a mixed environment that can move your machine inside to outside and vice versa. In this way, you can use only open parameter interface for both to control the Amazon and your internal machine. My deploy today is very simple. And we use a free app, is a written software for storage, for the image. And we have OpenQRM for the next JCP because we start with PKC and we need to make a mapping MAC address to the machine. We have OpenFS for user data, which is quite simple to move around. And user data generally is not so important. And especially we have a volume, is handled by volume. Some application and some written data. And we use a storage that we are discussing for all applications that need a special lock system. For example, that we need to hosting our login system. And you can handle in OpenFS. And especially for production environment, you are more secure. We have a production environment system for S6. With Bokanation local server, that means not start with PXA. Everything is on board for the machine. And we have a development environment based on one web server, KVM, or that read information from OpenFS and use Sun and use FreeNAS because many times the information on the development side is not so important. If you have a problem with FreeNAS, we can use information. We buy. In such a way, we have storage system, hardware system. No? Do you remember the slide? In the middle, we have object network. Everything is based on VLAN to keep separate or leave the machine for making dependent each machine to each other. And you can read also this slide. Okay, quite unstable because we don't know exactly the capacity, the service level agreement of VLANs. Quite good because it's quite stable OpenFS, good storage, this side. Good algo, the production, that common algo. When you use production in special way S6, you have a very short list of algo supported. On this side, I can use also a simple PC. That is also UKM one web server for cost reason. You cut off the cost. Here and here you cut off the cost. Also here you cut off the cost and has you can use a terabyte of data. Probably but for the people that want to know much more about OpenFS, I will take a very short lightning call about what OpenFS can do for you. Good for is a good, quite stable, a little bit old in the design, perhaps flexible to the PHP, quite simple to extend, and then very good to keep separate hardware from software. The idea is the operating system is high and hardware is out. You can consolidate all your instructions in a single point. Good level of hypability because you start to fast prototyping because you pick immediately you start up, you don't need to copy on the machine, start up immediately, you don't have time of copy. You will see that is not a limitation, but is something to get into consideration. Next one. Question about Eucalyptus. Eucalyptus is very young for my view. Is open source, is born as a research project of by the University of California, Santa Barbara, and was to understand how can you use cloud computing in scientific environment. If it's possible to substitute some task of a graphical computer. The idea was, okay, we need infrastructure, implementing private and hybrid because you can control inside outside. Why? Because everything is made with Amazon Web Service interface. They try to copy the web service of Amazon, try to implement the same syntax because we don't have standard today. The decision was you or use something. I think that the good idea was okay, we use Amazon that is first. Today, that is most important, and probably we'll see something on the keynote today. Eucalyptus is a company today and received $5.5 million of dollars. How is composed? We have three main pieces. The first piece is the cloud controller, and everything is inside of a cloud controller with storage and all the database of the information on the information or the resources. And also is the interface, the web service interface to the final user and web interface. We are a cluster controller that receives command from cluster flow and send command to node controller. Node controller is the interface with the virtual machine. You can simplify that. The node controller simplifies is the control start and stop your the command the external VM. That is a local machine on your environment. Right. Why that? Because this hardware, they one of the of Eucalyptus should be in universal environment, you don't have a specific hardware, high-end hardware, yes, something else you have, but you have a common hardware. The idea is some software that you can deploy in everywhere. The cluster control also makes some work about networking. That is the point of network administration. You can see that this cloud controller service receives information. All information is made security level with API, like Amazon. And everything is solution based on web security. On storage, you have two choices in this case. You don't have that in your virtual machine, you can mount NFS and so on. But storage that's tried to replicate also in this case the Amazon storage. We have Bonus, that's a replication of S3, and we have storage. This storage, one is a file and one is a database. No, a different name. Why we need the storage? We need the storage because when you turn off your machine on the cloud, like in Amazon, you lose all the data that you brought inside, that you need to write outside of your machine. Yeah, you can see most of the work on the Amazon. Amazon many times use S3 also for Elastic to save some information. Wireless, we said, is a file-based interface. It's not only a file-based interface. File-based is not an X. File-based is an application-based interface. Because you have a bucket. This is a bucket. Sorry, a bucket here. This is a bucket. Inside your bucket, you can save information based on K and the object. If you need to save a file on S3, you need to clear a key, draft the path. If you want, you can use the path as a key. The system path is the key. And you can save your file. You can also put some metadata on your file. And the policy. The bucket is fixed. It's a fixed size. And you can fill up with any case. That is not simple to write from there. No, it's not true. It's quite simple, but you don't have a file system interface in the way. It's more application interface. It's very useful. On the Eucalyptus side, the S3 is very basic. It's more a cool interface. It's a more web interface. It's a cool command. It's very simple. But you can put image on the S3. You can do that in Amazon. And also use web-based configurator. Today, you have a lot of limitations, no replication, no availability, no user interface, and so on. It's very basic. How can I write that? I can write a simple program in Perl, for example, that you can understand it's very HTTP. No, that's a simple. It takes some information, you create your key, and you send. You make put, or you make on HTTP. That you can do, but probably 20 times, you can find a lot. The block storage give you a block interface. You can format and create on it a file system. It's very similar to environment because you create extend, no, you can't extend, but you can create a snapshot, you can convert a snapshot to a disk and vice versa. And you mount, you find on your machine a new device that is a block. It's a plastic block. Now, one of the very nice things in Eucalyptus that you can deliver the system dynamically in four modes. This two mode is a common way that's HTTP based, with address fixed or not. The more advantage is a managed mode. You can create a single VPN for a group of machines that you can either make the isolation of your environment. Probably one of the things you don't find in other software. How can you do that? Oh, unfortunately, I don't know. I have. Okay. Because the virtual LAN obviously an interface, internet interface, that is connected to the page and separated from the local node. And in this way, you don't need to configure your switch environment, network environment. The virtual LAN is handled by local node. You can find more information on the paper, and you can explain much better the VDA, how it's handled. Also, you can give a public IP of your network. In this case, Eucalyptus creates two different interfaces, one for public and one for private, for communication in terms of your information that is joined to the group. The scheduler is very simple. You can decide to use a greedy, fun, or round robin. Obviously, the virtual that you are request must be fixed in the hardware. No, it must be compatible. How can you use it? You don't have any other solution. We use a free NAS This is mount Eucalyptus CSC because the CSC handles the wireless and the block device. Everything is here with CSC limitation. And we have to know to make some experiment that, simple system. That's simple from Ubuntu 19.4. That's included. You can make everything. Good for rapid prototyping. Yeah, very fast. Yeah, the copy of the machine can take 5-10 minutes, depends on the setup, because it's from the CSC cluster, it's copy the local machine to run, and takes the time of your network. But in the second run, the machine, the node, keep in cache the machine with the machine. First, you take probably the whole time of your bandwidth, and the second, you take any time to start up. It's very good for prototyping or developing, you have an application, you have some people that work on development, you have some bugs, you need to restore the environment in a certain time, you can start a new environment with the release where you had a bug with also it's very useful. So for installation, this is an Ubuntu startup also delivers service and many more will probably in the night time. Also, I don't talk about Grayscale. Grayscale gives you a service that you can handle Eucalyptus and Amazon with a single interface outside. You can walk inside outside. From RESTful free. You can see that on the RESTful side. Don't forget. Eucalyptus is not scalable as Amazon. If you install Eucalyptus, you don't have Amazon in your home. You have today only 256 nodes you can install. But Amazon probably, I think, use 257, probably, I don't know. It's a limit. This is implemented, is a good level, you have a lot of interface today, but S3 is very basic, you don't have all the functions today. But the big limitation today, mostly well, because everything is on CSC, you don't have redundancy. If you lose the CSC, you lose an old control, you lose all. The wireless, your device, you look at me. It's not possible today. The clip inside no has. Everything solution. The clip is not only a solution, there are other solutions. Sometimes very complicated, sometimes more, for example, advanced on the scheduler side. Lacking like in many times in interface or in storage and so on. But Eucalyptus probably this 5.5 million is we will see a lot of improvement in the next year. But if you want, you can check on also this solution. For example, from Globus UI solution for Globus that is Nebula, that's too complicated. There are others that are interesting, that is anomalism and survey. This one is a European project. Today, I think there's no code is possible to review because no code is required. And that starts a very good base, but it's a European project probably. We'll never end it. Okay, there's a little bit of advertising. We'll be at the European meeting in 2009 in Rome. Who can attend? Everyone wants to understand better when it comes to deploy and many other things. And probably we will find more developer of OpenFS from the United States and the UK in touch in technology and in the next future of OpenFS, like multi-master scalability on multi-master side and prior file and so on. Thank you very much. I think I give you an idea of how to set up and especially the limitation about this solution. And I don't give many details because I don't know the details. Anyway, because I think it's not a good idea. But I hope you enjoy the FrOSCon for all of you. Thank you. Bye. Thank you. No, for the question I'm here.